Hey guys, it's Adair. So it is 2017. Happy New Year to everybody who's watching this video. I have been gone for like 10 days. I was in Nigeria for the Christmas and New Year season, so that's why there was no videos or anything put out during that time. But I am so glad I'm finally back, and I wanted to come and shoot a kind of like my year in review and a little bit of Best of Beauty 2016, only because I don't want to do a whole video of Best of 2016. Unless you guys want that, then go ahead and request that below, and I'll try to put together a whole video. Honestly, this is kind of being done on the fly, so I'm really just picking stuff that's really kind of close by, stuff that really come to mind that I really loved for 2016. Brands that I love, not just like product, but brands that I loved and things that I loved for 2016, and also just kind of like a look back at some of the things that I did. And what 2016 was for me. So if you can tell, I did come back with some new Jessica Rabbit hair. I got this hair in Nigeria. It is from Good Hair, and I love this color. It is my first lace frontal. I've never had one before, and so I'm still trying to learn and play around with it. So this is my first time busting it out and like doing my makeup and everything and making sure I look like super slayed and all that kind of stuff. So I wanted to just do that, take some really nice pictures of this hair because it's really nice. It's this wine red color. If you know me, you know my favorite hair color is red. The first hair color that I dyed for myself was red, and I believe it was red, and I've been wanting to go back for the longest time, and so finally I'm back, but this time I had somebody do it for me. I also have another wig coming from them soon, which is going to be more of like my everyday wig, but I wanted to rock this one for this video and for my pictures. And I mean, like, how hot is this hair? Tell me if you guys like it. Oh, I usually show you guys the box that it comes in because the box is probably one of my favorite things of life. So this is a box that it comes in. Good Hair, and it's this gray and like light palish pink color, and it's like a purse, which I think is just so cute. And it opens up like this. It gives you a little bit of hair care tips. Number one, trust the brand. They are basically based in UK and Nigeria, but they do ship worldwide, and you can do custom orders, custom colors, all that kind of jazz. Check them out on Instagram and everything. I will put all their info down below. But yes, this box is so cute. I think this is probably one of the best boxes that I've seen from a hair brand and ever, forever. Let me give you the specs. It is 3 bundles of 16, and I don't even know what length the closure is. I mean, the frontal is. I don't remember. I think it's like a 14 inch closure or frontal. I'm so used to saying closure, but this is a frontal, so I'm just, you know, getting used to the new. So I'll go ahead and get started on my year in review first, and then we'll do some Best of Beauty. So 2016 was a good and bad year for me. It was a good year for many reasons. Let me say bad, because there wasn't a lot of bad, and bad is just, you know, more of like just uncertainty wise. Sometimes I was battling with myself a lot this year, and what it is and how it is I want to achieve what I want to do. Like, I know what I want to do, but it was how I was going to achieve it that I was really battling with. And I feel like this, as 2017 has come along, I'm able to get a better understanding, a better grasp of how I want to do what it is I want to do. There were, you know, some hard times, some struggling times. Everybody has, you know, those difficult moments in life, but I believe that, you know, God always was able to get me through it. I was able to be where I am right now. I made it a whole year in LA last year in September, so that was just a blessing in itself because I was ready to go back like a weekend. There are some cool things I did get to do in 2016, which I did want to mention. So one of the things I have to mention, and one of the first things I have to mention, is my trip with e.l.f. Cosmetics and the Beautyscape girls in July. It was probably it was so surreal. I've never won anything in my entire life, honestly. Well, probably like little raffles and stuff. I remember hearing the contest for the e.l.f. Cosmetics trip to San Francisco and the whole Beautyscape weekend. And the way I heard about it, which is funny, is that one of my friends, text me the link to Jackie Aina's video and was like, you should do this. And I was like, I don't know. I don't really like doing contests because I am very competitive, and when I lose, it makes me feel a certain type of way. But she's like, no, just do it. And anyway, if you do lose, at least you learn something in losing, which, and I was like, okay, yeah, you're right. So I went ahead, I watched Jackie's video. And if you know about the elk contest, there are three stages. There were three different stages where you could win. And Jackie's was the first stage. Then the 11th Gorgeous Girls was the second stage. And I Like Whaley was the third. And so I remember watching Jackie's video and it saying, okay, this is what you need to do. And I was like, okay, I got this. And I was like prepared, and I, you know, had, you know, planned a whole video of what I was gonna do, not a video, but a whole look of what I was gonna post and everything like that. And as the time went on, I didn't win. I was like, oh, seriously? Like, really? So the 11th Gorgeous Girls did their video and I was like, okay, this is the next prompt. And so I was like, okay, I planned a whole nother look. I was like, I'm gonna do something, this, you know, new thing. I think they were just focused on lips. And I was like, I got this. I have a whole idea for this look. So I planned it, executed it, did the same thing where I was checking the hashtag like almost every day, seeing, because the way they told you if you wanted, they would put a lipstick in your comment. And that whole cycle went through and I still didn't win. And I was like, oh, see, like, this is why I don't do this kind of stuff. This is why I never get in contests, because I never win. And so I got to the I Like Whaley video and I watched it and I was like, okay, whatever, I'm not even gonna try, because obviously I'm not gonna win. I'm just gonna choose one of my old pictures that I really, really love. Posted that picture, and I remember I was home back in Dallas, was what I mean. But I was back in Dallas for like a weekend or something, and I was in the living room, my parents' living room, and we were watching TV, and I was just looking through Instagram, and like, just, I literally just opened the Instagram app, and all of a sudden I see a comment, and I was like, oh, and I see Elf left a comment, and I look, and it has a little lipstick. And I was like, wait, what? Like, Like, I was like, wait, what? That's really all I could think of my mind. And then I got, you know, a message, and it said, you know, congratulations, you're a winner. You won the Beautyscape weekend. And I didn't believe it for like maybe 3 days. Like, I kept on clicking the Elf, like the name, to make sure it was going to the actual Elf page. I was waiting, they were supposed to get an email, and I think I didn't get the email till the next day, and I still was kind of skeptical. I just couldn't believe I won. And when I like really, really set in, I was just like, wow, I won. Like, I can't believe it. That whole weekend was just amazing. Meeting those girls honestly was probably the best part of it all. And even though, yes, we did get a lot of stuff from Elf, and we did get to do a lot of activities and really cool stuff and meet some cool like speakers, I still cannot believe. So yeah, I'm so appreciative to Elf for all they did for me, and for just allowing me to go on that trip like that. I just am so grateful for them. And yeah, definitely one of my huge moments for 2016. Another one I want to look back on is most of them are trips because I love to travel. But another one is, my other trip is when I went to Rio de Janeiro for the Olympics. That was a huge moment in itself, because me, like I said, I love to travel. My whole goal in life is to travel everywhere in this entire world. And so going to Rio was just like so cool. But just going to Rio for the Olympics just like topped it off for me, because if you know me, again, I love, love, love the Olympics. I look forward to it every 4 years. More the Summer Olympics than the Winter Olympics. Always said I'm gonna go to the Olympics one day, and the fact that I actually did go to the Olympics is just like mind-blowing. I can't believe, like, I was sitting there, because the night that we got there, we actually had an event. We went to the men's volleyball, beach volleyball match, and I was just sitting there looking, and I was like, I cannot believe I'm here. Like, I've been watching this on TV for years, and I'm actually sitting in the arena watching people play. It was like just awe-inspiring for me. I just couldn't believe it. It just really showed you that anything can happen in life. Like, you could just be sitting there watching something one day and just be there the next day. And I can't believe that I went. And I'm just, that was literally one of the top 10 things ever in this past like few years for me. And I do plan to go to Japan or into Tokyo 2020, so y'all should come too. But I don't know, I had such a good time watching all the events, seeing Simone Biles and Ali Reisman actually perform and do their floor routine, and seeing some of the men's basketball team do their thing. And I'm just like, seeing Usain Bolt, you know, win how many medals, and I was just like, this is it. Another top moment for me is when I was doing makeup on WizKid and featuring Effia's Daddy-O video. I did Effia's makeup, and one of my friends who is a fashion stylist, designer, like everything, he actually called me up and was like, hey, would you be interested in doing this? And I was like, yeah. And so that was just really cool again for me, because it was kind of one out of the blue, and two, like, just something that was cool, letting you know, like, just showing you what the future could be, like just doing music videos or me makeup for celebrities. And it's just, you know, was really cool for me. It's just been a really, really good year, and I think it just helped solidify my passion for what I want to do. All the weddings I went to, all the events that I went to, getting to go to a lot of the, like, after parties and screenings and meeting Denzel Washington. Like, yo, I met Denzel. We had a conversation. He was like the coolest person ever. Meeting just a lot of people, Viola Davis, going to different events that just had me in the room with some of my favorite celebrities. So yeah, 2016 was amazing, and I cannot wait till what 2017 has for me. I just hope it is bigger, better, badder than everything that I've done so far. I'm going to let go of, like, some of my anxiety and fears about stuff and just go for stuff. I have many goals for myself this year that I hope to achieve and to just blow out of this water, and I'm just gonna find whatever means possible in order to do so. The next thing I'm going to do is my Best of Beauty 2016. Now, I don't really know if all these products came out in 2016, but these are just some of the favorite things I loved using in 2016. You might have seen these in other things, other favorite videos, other videos of mine. I don't know if I'm going to be repeating. This is not everything that I loved, because again, this is kind of just like on the fly. And I just wanted to show you guys a few of my favorites. Maybe let's do like five or six, not like a real number, but I'll show you guys some of the favorite things that I loved for 2016, and that hope will be basically coming with me into 2017. First thing I want to talk about is the Anastasia foundation sticks. I love this stick, and I know I did a review on this and I was like raving about it, and to this day it stands true. I love this stick. This is the stick in chestnut, and if y'all can see, it's gone. Like, this is to the top, it's gone. I use this basically almost on a daily basis. Foundation I have on my skin right now. It is just such a great foundation that I am gonna be repurchasing this, and I hardly ever repurchase foundation. Really, really love this stick. I feel like it's just so great, easy to work with. I took that with me to Nigeria, easy to travel with. It worked well in Nigeria as well. The next foundation that I really loved, and you guys know, I've raved about this foundation like every damn time I talk about foundations. Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless. Like, y'all know how I feel. Let me not bore you guys again with my love for that foundation, but let me just say that that foundation has now been repurchased 5 times. 5. And when I say I don't repurchase foundations, I don't think you guys understand. I really like to try new foundations, and so I'm like to get new ones. That one, purchased 5 times. Let's just let it sink in. So this Clean by Melanie Mills Body Radiance, this is the old packaging, I know, but I love this. And I didn't really, the first time I used it, I wasn't impressed. I thought it was made my makeup too thick. But once I used more of it, I was like, yo, this is bomb. I can't wait to get Peach Deluxe from the one with the collab with Sandra Deluxe. But this is the rose gold. I basically use this almost every day for primer, and so I love this thing. It's definitely coming with me to 2017. Another thing I want to show you as a primer, I don't use it anymore, but I do want to give it its props, because it's one of those things that, even though it was such a huge, like, trend at one point, that I actually, usually when stuff is a trend, it's like, oh, like, whatever, it's just a trend, it'll go away soon. And it kind of has gone away, but I will say that this did hold up to its props. It is the Nivea Men's Skin Post Shave Balm in the sensitive version. I don't want to leave it up because it messes with the camera lighting, but it worked. It did, and it lasted me, I think I got it last December when I was right before I went to Nigeria. I took that with me and I think it lasted me for like 6 months or maybe even more. You get like, and it's like $7 or something like that. You get a lot of product for a small amount of money, and I think it's just, it works really, really well. I actually used it all up. I haven't repurchased it because I purchased new primers and I've been using this as my primer a lot lately. But I mean, honestly, if you're on a budget and you need a primer, I would still get that. Niki Tutorials was not lying to you when she was like raving about this. Everybody was buying it at one point just to test it and see if she was like, you know, see what the hype was about. And I think a lot of people were blown away by it. And so I honestly really, really liked it. So another thing that I have to say is my favorite. This has been my favorite for a long time, and I kind of stopped using it and then was reintroduced to it again. But the NARS Creamy Radiance in Caramel, I don't know why I stopped using it. I just wasn't thinking, and I thought, oh well, I'm just going to use other concealers, which I did. But this concealer is bomb, and I came back to it and I was like, why did I leave you? Like, you're my baby, I love you. And I got back into cream contouring, which I usually had stopped doing for a while, and I still kind of like don't really do it unless I'm going on special occasions. But I got the new color that they came out with, and this is Dark Coffee. Is this called Dark Coffee? Yeah, Dark Coffee. I got this color because I was like, okay, let me go back into cream contouring. And this reminded me why I like cream contouring in the first place. I just don't do it every day because it takes a little bit longer. But this reminded me of why I loved it in the first place. So sticking with my NARS train and products I loved, I'm going to be totally raving about this contour palette from NARS. And this is in Melina. This is like their darkest contour shade, and it has a kind of like a setting powder for your highlight as well, that's not yellow, but it's not like, it's kind of like a nude, which I really like to use too. I don't use it all the time, but I love this contour. I have been sticking with my Anastasia contour kit and using the refill and crop, which I still love and I still use on my clients and stuff. But this is just like super easy and compact. I can throw this in my makeup bag, which I really couldn't do with the other one because it has that like, it's a big palette. But this, I am so happy about. I love it. So a brand I want to give shout outs to, and even though I already kind of shouted them out during my year in review, is e.l.f. Cosmetics. Because let me just say this, and I don't want to say it like, oh, because they sent me on this trip is why I love e.l.f. now. No. Because honestly, I wouldn't use it still. It's not like, you know, what are they going to do to me if I don't use it anymore? I have to give e.l.f. their props because I think I had slept on them for a while. I had used them in the past. I love their brushes. I've always loved their brushes. I've been using their brushes like since I started doing makeup, but some of their products I was like, no, whatever. I kind of slept on them. Going on this trip introduced me to like some really, really great products that we have been sleeping on and have been letting go through the wayside because we were too busy trying to get the high-end stuff. And I won't blame y'all. I'll blame me. It was me. I have been introduced to e.l.f. and I love a lot of their products. One of their products that I really, really love, their makeup wipes. Their makeup wipes are bomb. I buy them all the time now. I have, you know, used them for my makeup kit. I just think they're bomb. I took them with me in Nigeria. They just clean out really well. They're very moist. Is that people hate that word. Then I use this, this Aqua bronzer. It looks kind of gross because I've been using it a lot in this product on the mirror. But I have extras of these anyway. But this bronzer is amazing, and again, sleeping on this product. I think a lot of people didn't realize that e.l.f. has some really great products. Another favorite from e.l.f. is their Lock-On Liner and Brow Cream, and this is an espresso. This for brows, just let me, like, I use it all the time, and the thing is, it actually is faster than using my Anastasia dip brow. I don't know why, like this, I can use a little bit, it does the whole brow and I'm done. And the last thing, which is what I just bought right before my trip, is the e.l.f. This is the last thing. The e.l.f. eyeliner I really, really love too. They have a mascara that's so small that's perfect for your underlashes, your bottom lashes. I don't have that one on me right now. This foundation though, why did I not give this a chance? This is almost on the same, this is literally battling my Maybelline Fit Me from my favorite drugstore foundation. I will say Maybelline still has it on lock right now, but this foundation, it went with me to Nigeria. It works really, really well. I was skeptical about it because they don't have a lot of shades, which I mean, I feel like they need to work on that and bring out more shades. But this foundation is super thick that I think is really good for the when it's cooler outside and your face doesn't produce as much oil. But I love this foundation. It actually blends in really nicely with my skin. I was nervous at first, like I said, because of the color shade, but I feel like it adjusted itself really nicely to my skin. Again, so y'all need to check out e.l.f. Again, I'm not saying this. They're not paying me to say this. They're not giving me anything for saying this. It didn't matter. I will admit the trip helped me realize how much e.l.f. like is cool and how much e.l.f. rocks. But it wasn't like, this is not the reason why. I could have just gone on the ship and then never talked about e.l.f. again. Trust me, there are people who have done that. This last product I'm gonna talk about, well, I'm gonna talk about this brand too. Dose of Colors, I had their lipstick. I had a full range of their lipsticks and they're still kind of packed right now, so I can't go show them to you. But I had a full range of their lipsticks and I didn't really use them because I was really on my Anastasia liquid lipsticks, and I wear them all the time and I still wear them all the time. But I started giving my Dose of Color lipsticks, you know, some airtime on my lips, and honestly, I don't know why I didn't wear them more often. Some of the color selections that they have are amazing. The one I have on my lip right now is their limited edition in Black Rose, and you guys, let me tell you. So this is bought recently, even though it's like still less than a month old, it's still gonna be in my Best of Beauty 2016. But I bought this right before my trip to Nigeria, wore it the first time there, wore it like 2 days there, and it was just, you know me, I love dark lipsticks. It's like the perfect color. And it's like a dark, like red, you know what I mean? Like, again, you can see it on my lip, it's just beautiful. It's totally my color. This lipstick is literally like me. This is exactly me in a lipstick right here. I love this color, and there's another color, well, there's three colors that I can name off the top of my head, including this one from Dose of Colors that I just, my favorite. So Merlot, which is like one of my favorite like dark blue reds that I really, really love for my skin tone. Cork and Pure Hollywood from Anastasia is like the best nude lipstick for me. Like the mixture together is like the best nude lipstick on me ever. And Chocolate Wasted is like the best brown ever. Like, I love that for a brown. And so I was sleeping on Dose of Colors for a long time, and trust me, I'm awake now and I'm not doing it anymore. They're definitely gonna be some of my top favorite picks for a while. And I will be rocking those lipsticks. And I think that's gonna be it for my Best of Beauty. Again, this is kind of spontaneous. I do wanna shout out Artist Couture for their highlighting. Their Diamond Glow powders were amazing. Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette, I gave that away too for my cousin when we did our swap, so I have to go repurchase that. But that's also part of my favorites. Also shouting out Tyra Beauty, because they actually had a pink lipstick that actually made me like pink lipsticks again, because I stopped liking them and I found a pink with them that I actually like. I can't think of any other brands right now, but yeah. So those are basically some of my top Best of Beauty for 2016. Let me know, what did you guys love in 2016? What was your like cool moments in your 2016 year in review, and what products were you totally loving last year? Again, this is off the top of the dome. If you guys want to see a more in-depth, I don't know if there's more you'd want to see, but if you want to see like a bigger review of my favorite products of 2016, let me know in the comments below. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'm excited about what 2017 has to bring. There are some things that I'm not excited about, Obama leaving, but there are some things that I am excited about for 2017. I'm hoping that it's a bigger and better year for me. I'm hoping to be doing some amazing things, learning more, educating myself more, and kind of just stepping out of my box, my box a lot more. Thank you guys so much. You guys are literally the reason for everything, and I just want to thank you guys for still rocking with me for 2017. I hope to grow this channel, grow my Instagram page, and just be a lot more consistent and a lot more present when it comes to those things. I just have a lot on my plate, but I'm just hoping to be a lot more present when it comes to all of that. Thank you guys again. Have a great 2017. I hope you guys, you know, if you haven't yet, please subscribe. to my channel, and also like and comment below and just let me know what you thought about this video. And have a great 2017, and wherever you are, I hope you have a great day and just blessed day, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.